first game jitters are gone now, Dick. Both of these teams are looking to settle into their comfort zone in this second-round matchup between the West Virginia Mountaineers and the Florida State Seminoles. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Seminoles are getting a very tough opponent tonight, Dick. What's the key to victory for them?
Hey, they've got to do the simple things out there, and they should be okay. First, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Next, try not to give up any good looks from the outside. And lastly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. 22 grabs it, and back they come the other way. Goes up for two, doesn't go, and the ball goes out of play. Both teams looking to get things going here. High post flasher is open. Leans in, number 14 with a finger roll. On the outside, he's open if he wants the shot. Goes in.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
You are being used as a launching pad.
Dumps it in. The center with the ball. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. He looks for the bomb. He can't miss.
And this young man's feeling it, Brad.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. He went for the steal in the post and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And in and out. They look to get it to the inside. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Trying to feed inside. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The Mountaineers are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. He hits the first shot.
Makes those free throws count. Wants to go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
He fakes the shot. He tries a jump hook and off the mark. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
The Seminoles will step to the line for the first time. He got it. Sinks both of them.
Trying to go inside. That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
The small forward gets the ball. Jumps into the defender. Jumped in front to take it away. Number 11 is feeling great right now.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
can't get the shot to drop. A nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked it and took it to the basket.
It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
For two, doesn't go. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Off the rim and no good. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Looking for a good shot. Arm and foul. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Aaron. Dribble, gives it up from three-point range. Dick, these guys are tearing it up from the three-point line.
Give me more threes, please. I love watching these kids drop the trifecta. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Tries for two.
They let him get into a rhythm. Hey, Brad, a stop here will definitely raise the decibel level.
The power forward takes the pass. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
And he missed. Number 42 takes the feed, kicks it out. He shoots, way off target. The point guard gets the pass.
Gotta think right now, gotta focus defensively.
He attempts the three. The Mountaineers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Ratty's on fire.
Comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Off the rim and no good. Now they work it around the perimeter. From three-point territory, way off target. Gave it up.
Dump it inside.
They've left him completely alone. He shoots from right of the circle. Number 25 is trying to get the crowd pumped up.
He wants the crowd excited for this offensive possession.
Goes.
Roll it back, fellas.
Block and immediately goes with a shot. The Seminoles have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple. Double team now, bad angle.
Problem with that when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play out there and you front it.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
takes the shot. The ball goes out of play. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. Puts it up, looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. He shoots from the top of the key. That's good. They're working around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That layup will count for two, plus the hard.
Hey, he sized the defender up and protected the ball going in for the layup. Boy, was that beautiful. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Got a wide open look. He shoots from the top of the key.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
On the outside. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Puts up the shot. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick TO, baby. That's basic.
Kicks off the lazy pass. Shot clock is dead. Number 14 with the theft and the slam. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
At the half, the Mountaineers are ahead by two. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin. For two, basket falls despite the contact. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He's money with a shot. Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler.
He kept his dribble and ran the defender right off the screen for a beautiful jump shot, Brad.
And now they'll bring it up with the fake. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
They work the perimeter. He looks at the hoop. For the bucket, they still don't score. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Mm-hmm. skip pass is picked off. Tries for two. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. He intercepts it. For the bucket. And off the mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. He dials long distance. Off the rim and no good. The power forward handles the feed. It's stolen. Looking for a good shot. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
In the paint. Hard foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
High post flashes. Lobs it inside. He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad. I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Working it around the perimeter. From right of the circle. Rims out. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. For two.
I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Pushes it up. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Take it away.
Nothing better come easy tonight, baby.
They are really playing for keeps. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Number 11 fakes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The power forward receives the ball. Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
West Virginia are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Controlling the ball. Strips the ball.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Drops the bucket despite the harm. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
With a block. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
Unloads a three.
Man, he used that screen to perfection. He used it to get free, baby, for the good look.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Moving it around the perimeter. For the deuce. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Show the replay on that. Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
And the ball goes out of play. Got the high pick. Fires it down. Takes the pass in the paint. Up fake.
There's the trap.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
Off the rim and no good. The point guard handles the pass.
Up and inside.
The shooting guard receives the pass.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go. Just play, son, just play. Let your game do the taunting.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes it. Like in practice. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
He pump fakes.
Step out on that screener.
Rims out. Number 42 with the fake. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Got some room. He shoots from the top of the circle. He clangs the three-point attempt. The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting a good inside angle, a poor job defensively, no help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
On the outside. And his shot rejected. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Well, I think she's right about that, Richie. Well, we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
Pushes it. And a slam. 2-point game. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot. Defense doing a great job pushing the basketball.
Number three steals the ball. We go. The lead is down to a bucket.
Hey, this place is about to explode. It's dynamite, baby.
Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball. Surprised that they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
Shot clock is dead. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Tries for two, and he missed. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. With a deep shot from outside. Off the rim and no good. And this one, Dick, is going to be decided in overtime.
That's the way this one has gone all game, Brad. Don't head for the exits yet. These teams are headed into overtime.
College basketball fans have gotten more than they even bargained for in this NCAA tournament because they get more for their buck overtime, Richard.
I tell you, we got two evenly matched clubs that have really responded. The PTPers are playing well, the stars, the coaches have their teams prepared, and it's all going to get down, I believe, to the free throw line at the end of this game.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He better get rid of it. Top of the circle. Makes the shot. He's getting lost on every move.
We got to see more heart on defense.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
For the bucket. Rims out. They're working around the arc. There's the fake. He rejects it. The ball goes out of play. Dick, let's take a look right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
He tries the three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post play.
And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, the spin back the other way.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. Sinks it. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
For the deuce. No. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
Takes it off him. Transition opportunity coming up. Goes up for two. Student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
He unloads a three. The Mountaineers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brady's on fire.
Gave it up. And he'll kick it back outside. Here they come with a double team to stop it. The ball goes out of bounds. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
Off the rim and no good. Into transition. Top of the circle, they're working around the perimeter. For two, he puts it in with contact and all. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. Puts it up. Rims out. Pulls down the board.
Filled the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities. He posterized him.
That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
Visit the charity stripe. Buries it.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
6 points is the difference.
Wow, do they need a basket badly, Brad. Momentum will decide it. They need a foul here. Hold on, let's see that again.
Looking for a good shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. How do they respond here, Dick?
Well, quick baskets, quicker fouls, Brad. No in between.
Maybe some game plan changes, Dick?
You never know what's coming, Brad.
The lead is six.
Hey, a tray here in this place will go absolutely bananas, Brad. I can feel it.
Off the rim and no good. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And yet another foul. Stops the clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Number 14 goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Second shot is good. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Start things up again. Dick, 6-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
Rims out. Kicks it out. He looks for three. Tickles the twine. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Number 22 goes to the line for the 1-1. Sinks it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Hits the second.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one possession game.
Now in a half court, let's see what they set up, Dick. From way outside, off the rim and no good. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Mountaineers graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.